Hello everyone, my name is Alex Chaunt, test pilot here at Skyryse. Welcome to Skyryse One. This is an R66, which if this was a normal helicopter, we would have behind here push-pull tubes, bell cranks, yoke flanges, and everything else to have mechanical control from the pilot all the way through to the control surfaces of the main rotor and the tail rotor. But that all is gone in here, replaced by a fully digital, triply redundant fly-by-wire system. Behind here, we actually have our linear actuators, which transmit all of the commands from the FCCs, the flight control computers. We have a separate actuator, the other side, controlling the engine. And then we have another actuator as well, the other side, controlling the tail rotor. They're all driven through the flight control computers. We have taken all of the conventional controls out and replaced by single inceptor and touchscreens. Fly-by-wire technology, in its simplest sense, is instead of having one conventional pilot or two, and you've now got essentially four pilots, right? You have three flight control computers. There's actually no direct linkage anymore between the pilot's controls and the control surfaces. You have pilot, then you have their inputs all going electronically into the flight control computers. Once they've voted and all of the inputs from all of the sensor suite around the aircraft to come in as well, then the outputs of that voting will then get transmitted to the control surfaces. So that level of redundancy is enormous compared to a conventional control, that all of the fallibility of the pilot is now taken out of the equation. Let's go inside and actually have a look at the cockpit. The first thing you'll notice is it's nice and airy. There's a lot of room in here and there is no conventional controls. So I have a single inceptor right here for my left hand and two high visibility touchscreens, and they essentially give me all the information I need to keep the aircraft safe. The inceptor here, the easiest way to describe this is right is right, left is left, forward is accelerate, aft is decelerate. So kind of like a cyclic, but it actually incorporates a lot of the controls together. So rather than a traditional helicopter, when I need to go forward, but I don't want to descend, not only do I have to go forward on a cyclic and up collective and push some left pedal and counterclockwise road systems, simplified vehicle operations, all I need to do now is go forward. So I've taken three control inputs into one input. If I'm on the ground and I want to control yaw, now you just twist the stick. And now, instead of the collective, we have the VTL here, the vertical toggle lever. So I just rest my thumb, squeeze it up when I want to go up, squeeze it down when I want to go down. And here it is purely a rate command for increasing and decreasing altitude. Combining axis is very easy as well. As you can see here, I can keep my thumb on the stick. I can twist left and right. I can roll longitudinal, lateral, and heave. I can manipulate the aircraft very, very easily by just moving the stick around. So I think it's worth touching now on the subject of precision, because a lot of people obviously got questions about, you know, how can you precisely control a helicopter which has traditionally been very difficult to fly with something so small. What I can say is it's not just the stick that gives the precision, it's the entire system. It's the fact that you've got computers transmitting to the actuators, unlike a traditional semi-rigid system with push-pull tubes, they take out all of that mechanical advantage and slop in them, so that you get instantaneous response in the control stick. It gives me an inherent feel very, very quickly because of the precision of the actuators, because of the speed of the signals. The simplicity is quite simply astounding. SkyOS is our operating system. We really split it up into two basic fundamental displays. We have a primary flight display at the top, which gives us all our basic attitudes and airspeeds and all the other stuff that you get as a pilot. So then we come down to our MFD, a multifunction flight display here. You have all your engine parameters on the right-hand side, your traffic, your auto flight, your emergency functions. Everything is available at a touch of a button to go through. What's interesting about this cockpit layout is because I don't have a collective now, I have an armrest, so it's almost like a high-end car in some ways. I just have what I need. It's very, very easy to start the aircraft. So we go through a system check where we will check that the control stick is moving in all of the axis that it needs to. Then we can go into an actuator's check, which is kind of the internal test of the whole aircraft, where all of the actuators will go through their full control movement. Then we can go on weight and balance, and then you go into engine control. You know, we've already got green here. We disengage the rotor brake and then just confirm the area clear. Once you've done that, swipe your finger. And that's all you do. You just swipe to start. You monitor the engine parameters. There is an abort button for whatever reason you need to override something. Once you've done that, then all you've got to do to go to flight idle again is just swipe the control and N2 and NR will start spooling up to flight idle. We have actually two methods of picking the helicopter up. We have what's called swipe to pick up, literally a swipe of your finger. SkyOS will bring you up to a stabilized 6-foot hover without you doing absolutely anything. But you also do have the option of doing a manual pickup, and really all you have to do is actuate the VTL. The aircraft will automatically trim itself out to a neutral position with a stick. Once you're in a hover in this aircraft, it does it all itself. Whether I'm in a hover, feeling squirrely, I'm going into the clouds, I'm in a brownout, in a whiteout, whatever it may be, inherent stability has a safety feature that will right the aircraft instantaneously when the pilot literally just lets go of the stick. At any phase of flight, that's all you've got to do. The aircraft will right itself and it will maintain heading, and it'll give you that time to be able to make decisions on what you want to do next. Now that we're in a stabilized hover, let's talk about how we would execute some regular hover maneuvers. It's again very intuitive, left or right twist. You know, the maximum deflection is probably only about 25 degrees, so you don't have to rotate your hand all the way around to get maximum deflection. If I want to, you know, move myself laterally across a taxiway, then I'm simply going to move the stick laterally, left or right, and the aircraft will roll left, roll right, and move itself across the tarmac. If I want to back up a little bit, I just back up a little bit. If I want to start getting a bit more fancy and combining axes together, say I want to do a pirouette down the runway or something like that, or around a point, then yes, I could do exactly that. I can command forward on the stick to get some airspeed, and then at the same time, I can start twisting the nose. So, you know, pirouettes just end up just being a manipulation of the axis together. To take off in Skyryse One is an extremely simple routine from a stabilized hover. So all we'd need to do is we would ease the stick forward until we start to feel the aircraft moving forward. The aircraft will get itself through ETL. Once you're at 40 knots, then you can just ease up on the VTL. The aircraft will continue to climb, and you'll just keep pushing forward till you reach the desired airspeed. Then you'll just release the stick. So once you're up and away, it's extremely simple. You are literally just commanding what you want in what we call a velocity-based control system. You know, whatever airspeed, whatever rate of climb, whatever bank angle, you just command it and it'll do it. Now, where this system sets itself apart is something that we call flight envelope protection or dynamic envelope protection. In a nutshell, SkyOS will not allow you as a pilot to put yourself in it. Undesirable aircraft configuration. Great examples of this are settling with power, which leads to vortex ring state, and low G leading to mass bumping and main rotor separation. Two very, very serious issues that SkyOS will not allow you to get into that situation where it could affect you. Another huge plus is the recognition and management of potential emergency situations. One of the biggest maneuvers that we practice in helicopters is autorotation practice, right? Which is mainly used in the event of an engine failure, tail rotor, drive shaft failure. SkyOS will recognize that there is a failure of a critical component that necessitates an autorotation and will put you automatically into a stable autorotative state. And believe me, I've done enough of them in this aircraft to know that it enters into autorotation very, very quickly and very stably. It will establish a 70 knot stable glide very, very quickly and enable you to start looking for your landing spot. For the approach phase, honestly, the most of your time is spent just looking at your landing spot, and really all you've got to do on the stick is dictate how fast you're going down and dictate your rate of closure. So that set down process, the most simplistic way of doing it is when you're in a stable hover, you can just let go of the controls and swipe down and, you know, essentially sit and have a cup of tea at that point, right? That's it. The aircraft will control its lateral longitudinal positioning, and then it will also control its rate of descent. So to come down and cushion the landing and set down with no lateral side slip. Well, that's it. Thank you so much for touring us. We look forward to seeing you all in the skies up in Skyryse One in the future.